Hello, ladies and gentlemen, how are you? Thank you for tuning in Adult Education Ingredients. My name is Rosalia Wong. Today, I'm going to bring you the social, psychological, emotional, and spiritual development can affect your cognitive development. The study and research was by Wolf 2005. There are many authors contribute this kind of articles to his book. And one of the author called Gabrinsky, in Gabrinsky's article, he was describing a woman encountered her terminal illness called cancer. So how is she going to cope with this? How is the family going to cope with it? So the family and herself went through the oncologist, and oncologist told them to have to go through the process in a hospital, where the hospital can give them the strategies and ways to cope with this kind of situation. And unfortunately, this is a scenario that we all encounter in a certain stage of our life, which is life and death. So it is a very hard moment when you first inform that it is a deadly disease that you have to go through. So the hospital helped the women and the family to go through the program and also analyze the actual the facts about this the situation, how to the process that going through their mind and their body. And this is a very natural situation that they need to cope with it, because we cannot they cannot avoid death. So how are they going to go through? So the hospitals took them to a counseling program, or a group of people, the patients. They are also went through the same situation as them, but different scenario. And they all grouped together. They have a study group, and they also have a like storytelling group, and they work their lives, help each other to cope with all these situation. So they're in the group, they will tell the story and they release their emotion and come to the realizations that they can accept it. The fact is, Wolf described the scenario, what's going on in our body, in our mind, when we accepting this kind of very difficult news that we have to accept. The fact is, the cognitive development need to align with social, psychological, and emotional and spiritual development. How do we bring the cognitive level to the same level as the four realms? So, in order to bring them, to align them together, Wolf was describing that the study group, the storytelling group, and also in elderly retirement village hostel, they can have elderly hostel, and they can have together they can do a program or do a non-traditional degree to level up their situation, to level up their knowledge, and do something that can release their emotions. In this way, the alignment of cognitive and social and the four realms can come together. And that is how they can accept and cope with the real situation. Another of his author called Kagan was narrating that once that he went through the train station, he was going to catch a train, and as soon as he was approaching the revolving door, which is leading to the inner side of the train station, and he encountered women. The women was security guard dressed in the normal uniform, and she was approaching Kagan and asking him to identify himself. But Kagan at that time was thinking that she was asking for money, and realized that she was actually the security guard. So he took out all the cards from his purse and one by one, but at the same time he saw the trains approaching. So he quickly he quickly grabbed the cards from the women, from the security guard, and ran towards the revolving door. Just as he was approaching the other side of the revolving door, unfortunately his arm was stuck inside, and he can see his arms holding all the cards. But at the same time, the other side, he could see the train approaching. So what he could do at that moment, there was a lot of thoughts going through his mind. What if he drops his cards and just ran towards the train, and he has no problem to catch the train? And the story ended that way, because Wolf is not interested in what's happening to Kagan. Wolf in 2005 only interested in the internal process of Kagan at that moment. So how he was panicked. So how is he going to cope with it? So Kagan actually in kind of shock, he went through the he wrote the story, and only writing the story he recovered and have his realization that next time similar thing happened to you in a certain situation, he will not be panicked, because that is not the end of the world. Even though he dropped the cards, he still can apply for it when he went back home after the train, and he still can ring up and apply for the cards, and it's not the end of the world. It's just that at that moment you get panicked because you don't know what to do, and because this is not a familiar situation. So if you know the fact that this is actually in the internal process that give you the panic, it actually the alignment, the cognitive development is not aligned with your four rhymes. And if you can bring that up, you know, next time you will know that, you know, you will not panic, because you know the internal process, this is that way. It's not, because at that moment you might think that this is the end of the world, but it's not the end of the world. It's actually the internal process telling us. It's sent for everything. Everything happening is actually our internal process, our mind. Yeah. In fact, you know, this is not knowledge we have learned from Wolf, and he's given us very good information. And anyway, please do subscribe to my channel and like my videos. I will bring you more next time, and every Monday I will give you a new ingredients. And stay tuned, and thank you for tuning in, and thank you for listening, and goodbye.